a preacher, a pastor, put up his face. He has been charged with trying to prank on a 7-year-old girl. Let's put this picture up full mass. You're looking at Kenneth Daniel, Alabama pastor of a Jefferson County church, has now been arrested. 64 years of age, was arrested at the First Baptist Church where he serves as their senior preacher. He was charged with facilitating and solicitation of unlawful sexual conduct with a 7-year-old child. He was booked into the county jail on the felony charge. Let me give you the background. According to case documents, the alleged crimes took place between January 2020 and earlier this month. A 7-year-old victim told her grandfather that Daniel had been sexually abusing her. The girl reported that the preacher had touched her private parts numerous times at his residence, a pool party, and also at the church itself. The victim said the pool party was arranged by the preacher, Daniel, who requested the victim's grandfather bring her and other children to the party. The affidavit says Daniel contacted the grandfather by phone for arrangements to bring the victim to locations where the abuse happened. The state is requesting the highest possible bond as it relates to Daniel. Blount County DA Pamela Casey said Daniel has family in Japan, which makes him a flight risk. The preacher has been ordered to surrender his passport. Daniel remains in the county jail as of Thursday. CBS 42 reached out to church officials for a statement and they have heard back from no one. We're going to continue to follow this story. Let me tell you why. The church that this preacher is a part of, this church has some significant connections to the community. So does he. He has significant connections to those that work in the justice system for that county. Now, right now, this is obviously an ongoing investigation process. But the testimony that already exists from at least one child is so compelling and the details are so gruesome that they had to effect an arrest warrant immediately upon this preacher. And I highlight this story to remind everyone who has a child and who works with children. There are monsters in the world. There are monsters in the world. These monsters will come cloaked in a disguise. And that disguise is typically that of a good person, of a decent individual. Remember the psychological profile. These types of people seek positions of public trust in order for you as a parent, for you as a youth worker, to lower your skepticism, to lower your caution, and to allow them in. We've reported on these preachers many times on Indisputable. I do this as a reminder to everyone. Check, observe, look for signs. You don't get another opportunity here. You don't get to take back whatever happened to that child, okay? Prayerfully, she gets help, she gets counseling, she has protection. But what happened, happened, according to the report. All right, Ben, thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, and like, there's so many layers to this. The first layer is, if this person is 64 years old, he's probably been a preacher for a while. Yeah. And he's been a preacher for a while, and he's like, he said that he's the head preacher of the church, right? That might be indicative of probably a long history. This isn't something that just happens one time. And another layer to this is right now we're in the middle of this giant moral panic across the country where you have people that are trying to blame random marginalized people for like sexual assault and stuff like that. Especially right now it's targeted towards queer folks. But obviously in the United States, there's a long history of like blaming random black folks and things like that. But you need to understand that the same people that push those narratives are also the same types of people that commit acts of abuse like this. And the reason for it is very simple. They do not want you to be looking at the people that are actually in your proximity. They want you to be looking at people that are others. And the reality is that if there is a situation where a child is being sexually abused in one way or another, it's usually somebody that is a person of trust. It is usually somebody that is like a family member or a teacher or a preacher, somebody that has some sort of tie to the family, right? Somebody that has some sort of trust or respect within the community. It's not usually some random out there person that's just coming from the middle of nowhere and like kidnapping people or whatever. And the unfortunate reality is people spend so much time pushing like racist, homophobic, transphobic narratives around crime in general that like marginalized people get like state violence targeted towards them from the police, when the reality is that you should really be more involved in keeping your community safe, keeping your circle safe, and really scrutinizing the people that are interacting with your children on a daily basis. It's not going to be some random person. It's going to be somebody like a preacher.
Yeah, and here's the thing, conservatives, they're saying, well, if there's a violation of a child, that child who has been abused must birth a fetus if that happens, which to me is another form of abuse by way of policy. All right, we're going to continue to follow this story.